during all the high school years, I was always helping my father, Merlin Morris, plant his crop. And I knew from the very beginning that that was going to be my career, especially with the heritage that our farm had. I went to school at Jonesboro at Arkansas State University, studied in ag, obtained a degree in plant science, graduated in 1970, went into the Air National Guard to serve my country. And then I settled on the farm and helped my dad. And then after he passed away in 1976, in 1977, I began my career as a fourth generation on the rice farm. Then I had my own family and had a son, Matt Morris. He became the fifth generation rice farmer now. He also has three sons. If they so choose to be rice farmers, it'll be the sixth generation. And I'm very happy to see that our family heritage and name will continue on.
I really started probably when I was about 15, is when I really started on the tractor driving and doing the labor at work and things like that. We've always been real close. So for me to be able to work with my father out here with him every day, spending time with him, and us just being a father-son team, it really brings joy to my heart. And then with my sons being out here, we have three generations in a row working out here some days.
After I began my full farming career in 1978, it was very shortly after that that we began to have serious problems with our groundwater. Even in the early 70s and on, we began to notice our wells, they began to drop off so dramatically that we knew that we were going to do something different. In 1980 was the drought that woke everybody up. We realized that we were not only in a critical groundwater area, but our livelihood depended on it. So in 1981, I began to have a 60-acre reservoir built with the help of the Soil Conservation Service. They did the total design for me. I picked out this place I wanted to have the reservoir built, the size of it, my ideas about what I needed. But every step of the way, they were there to do survey, recommendations, help stake off the levee and everything that needed to be done.
In 1980, Richard Moore saw the need to address water quantity here on Merlin Morris Farms. Through conservation planning, that 60-acre irrigation reservoir was designed and implemented. That reservoir provided him surface water and addressed his water quantity needs at that time.
I purchased some property across from this reservoir in the 1990s. I built a tailwater ditch using the tailwater surface water totally as a source of irrigation. The Soil Conservation Service helped me with the design on this particular ditch also, show me what could be done and how to do it.
Tailwater recovery system, which allows the Morris family to capture rainwater and runoff which leaves these fields. By using surface water, the Morrises are moving towards sustainability of both a sixth generation family farm and an industry that this family and farm helped create.
Last year we built another reservoir on Merlin Morris farm with 20 acres with the help of the National Research and Conservation Service. They did the total design. We had a quarter mile long surface tailwater ditch plus the 20 acre reservoir, and I see it's going to be very successful in reaching my goal of 100% surface water irrigation. We will not be using the well. Our amount of rice we raise feeds several hundred people. And we've been doing this for over 100 years. And in fact, we received our Arkansas Century Farm Award in 2012. So we've been at production of rice for a long time. We're very proud of our heritage. We are proud to be a part of the rice production and rice industry in Arkansas.